So the first app I wanted to talk about is the Better Display app. This app lets you control different monitors and different displays settings separately. So let's say I'm on my monitor right now, I can control the brightness of my monitor, I can control the volume, and I can also control the resolution of my monitor depending on what it supports. But I can also control the built-in display of my MacBook, I can control the brightness, and I can control the resolution of it as well. I can even control the refresh rate to change the ProMotion, or I just want to do it at 60Hz, I can do that. The same thing with my external monitor, I can change the refresh rate to how much ever I want. Instead of controlling through the back of my monitor, it's much faster and way better than going into the settings, looking around for these other options. Switching monitor display with this app is quite simple. Let's say I'm on my BenQ right now and I have this set to the main display and I want my monitor to be the secondary one instead and my built-in display to be the main one. So what I'm gonna do is go into built-in display and then come down here. And you can see here, I can set this thing to main display. So once I do that, right now what I'm seeing is it has already switched the display for me. So if you come in here and check, our built-in display is now the main display. Right now I'm recording on my monitor, so you can see the files are now gone, the folders are gone, everything's on the main display now. But what if I want my monitor to be the main display again? Then I can just come down here and set it back. And there we go, we are back. It is that simple to do. However, there's one thing I wanted to talk about. It's the high resolution. This just sounds like something that isn't that useful, but this is probably the reason why I use this app till today. Sure, the brightness and main display settings are very easy to use and are much convenient than the default ones. This high resolution is a game changer. If you are currently running on a 1080p monitor or any other monitors, let's say I don't have this on, just look at my desktop and just look at it carefully. Right now it's super clear, everything is sharp and smooth, but if I turn this off, you could see that it's a little bit blurry now. I'm not sure if you can see much of a difference from the video, but for example, if you look just in the middle, if I go ahead and turn it back on, everything becomes so sharp. You could just look up here too. I'm gonna do it again. So if I turn it off, look at that. For some reason to my eye, it is not as clear and as sharp, but if we try to do it again, it's like my monitor just went from 1080p to 1440 or something like that. So it just increases the resolution of your monitor while still maintaining the refresh rate that you like set it to. This is probably the game-changing thing. If you do a lot of coding or you do a lot of reading, and you'll notice that the text in when you read is a bit blurry or way too sharp if you have this off. This is the default one. You can see the text is clear, but it's too sharp and it's a bit like pixelated around the corners. But if you turn this on, there you go. The text and fonts just seems a lot more clearer and smoother around the corners. It's a lot easier to read now. To download this app, you can just go to your browser, search Better Display, and click the link with GitHub, and you'll see it's the one by Mr. Way Dabber, and you can just click on the download for Mac OS, and it should download the zip file for you. The second app I want to talk about is called Drop Zone 4. Once you downloaded Drop Zone 4, you should see it in the menu bar. Clicking it will just give you a drop-down menu like this. You can add something to a grid, such as your folders. Just drag the folders and drop it to a grid. Now it's just gonna stay here forever, right in the stack. Or you could have it as a drop bar, so you could drag some image or a file and just drop it in here. And it is just available to you right here, and you can drag it anywhere now, just from here. So very useful. But the drag to airdrop is my favorite one here. What I can do with Drop Zone is just drag the image I want, come up here, hover over it, and then go to airdrop. And now you can just drop to any other Apple devices that you have available in the proximity. This works with any files and not just images. You can see how easy that is to do. With Drop Zone, I can just drag an image I want from a website, go up here, and drop it in the drop bar. Now the image stays in your drop bar forever. You can do whatever you want with this image. You can just go back to your desktop or drag this thing out to desktop, and there it goes, it's there, or you could just drag it back in again. Once the image is now placed inside the drop bar, you can pretty much drag it to any other websites or applications that you need to. It is much more efficient than just going to the downloads folder where you usually download your images. Instead, if you want to do it really quickly, you can just drop it right here and it stays there until you take it out. You could just right click and then press to remove it, the same way as for folders. The free version of Drop Zone 4 works well enough, but if you want some extra features, things like move to trash, you have messages, you have Google Drive, you have copy file, move files, but these are the features that you're probably gonna have to pay for, but I think the free version is good enough. To download Drop Zone 4, you can just go to the App Store and find Drop Zone and download it. Okay, let's move on to Neptunes. This app is probably going to be for music lovers, because if you listen to a lot of music while working, this is going to be the app for you. Because every time you work on something and you want to have to switch tracks or keep track of what you're listening to, you're going to have to come into the control center and then, oh, play, pause, and switch to the next one. But you can't go to the previous one. You can't even press repeat. You can't even press shuffle or favorite anything until you actually click into it one more time. But if you use Neptunes, it has a pop-up window that gives you an album art look and lets you favorite your tracks. You have control of the tracks right in front of you. You could play, repeat, shuffle, or go to the next song or previous song using this small little window right here. But there's one setting that you need to change, which is this one, the window widget behavior, and just change it to above. What this means is if you open other applications, this thing will always be above. So no matter what you open, this is always going to be the one floating above everything else. And I don't see the point of not using the widget, because if you just turn this off, then it's just pointless to use this app in the first place. So having the widget on is probably the reason why you want to use this app. And you could also do a player switching, change it to Apple Music or Spotify, really up to you. For this one, you can just go ahead and download it from the App Store. If you guys are liking the video so far, be sure to hit that like button down below, and let's get back to the video. Let's move on and talk about some of the other quality of life apps you can have on your Mac. This one's called the Hidden Bar, and it just allows you to hide the menu bar icons in a little tray on the side. Just makes things a little bit cleaner to look at. You can find this and download it from the App Store. It's free, and all you have to do is just download it, open it up, and it will give you this option. So what you want to do is hold the command button and just drag whatever apps you want to hide into the menu bar, and that's pretty much it. It's actually recommended to me by one of my very good friend, and I'm still using it till today, and it's a very, you know, simple, easy, and free to use app. Now this next app is called Keyclu. What it basically does is when you press the command key down once and then press it again, but this time hold it down, it should pop up a list of commands for that specific application. Let's say I'm in Arc right now and I hold my command down and hold it again, and then you should see a bunch of command pop up. You can go ahead and search this up on your browser and go into the one that says ANSI Keyclu Cask, the GitHub page. From here, you can just scroll all the way down until you find the command and links. If you are familiar with the shell commands, you can go ahead and download it using Homebrew, but if not, you can just click that link and download the DMG, open it, and then you can just drag the app to the applications folder. All right, so the next one is called Linear Mouse. Linear Mouse lets you control the settings for your mouse, no matter what mouse you're going to be using. I currently am using an MX Master 3, which has its own settings built into it, but if you are using a mouse that does not have a built-in software or setting, you can go ahead and download the Linear Mouse here, which allows you to config every single part of your mouse, including the scrolling speed, scrolling acceleration, or a reverse scrolling, which will probably go in reverse to the natural scrolling. And you could also adjust the pointer acceleration and pointer speed, or if you don't love acceleration, you can just turn it off totally. And the settings will be saved for each mouse, as it auto detects each mouse that is plugged into the settings. You can switch between the primary and secondary buttons, and it also has a setting specific for each app that you could do, or for each monitor or each screen that you have built in. To download this, you can just go to your browser and click in the first link you see, and then you can just download it straight away, or just install it using Homebrew. Karabiner Elements. This app is going to specifically be for your keyboard. If you're someone who wants to use a Hyperkey, this is the app to do it in. If some of you guys don't know what a Hyperkey is, it's basically a key on your keyboard that you have set it to Control, Shift, Option, and Command, meaning that no other keybinds can ever go over the Hyperkey. So this key would be the shortcut key for your main keybinds on your device, such as for switching apps or for doing a quick screenshot or anything you want to set it to. Resetting your function keys to do a different kind of control settings. If you have a custom keyboard, you could also use an application that comes with that. To download it, you can just go to the browser and search it up and click the first link you see, and there should be it. In this video, I'm only going to be talking about how you set up the Hyperkey for any keyboard. Okay, so to set up the Hyperkey, all you have to do is come to the Complex Modification tab. Then what you want to do is copy this code I have right here. Just copy this code. Now, once you copied it, what you want to do is go to this tab right here and click on Add Your Own Rule. Once you click on that, you might not see anything in this section right here, but if you do see something, just paste the one that you copied in here, then press save and close this tab. Once you do that, be sure to turn on the one that you just created, and then that should be it. You don't really need to understand it, because if you really need to understand it, I can just make a whole nother video about Karabiner Elements, because it's just basically JSON in here. But yeah, if you want it the easy way, then you can just copy this code and just paste it in there. I will leave the code down in the description below. Okay, the next app we're going to be talking about is called Amphetamine. Once you download Amphetamine, you will see this little pill up here in the menu bar. Right clicking it will activate the pill. Now your Mac screen will never fall asleep ever again. And yeah, that is pretty much what it does. But let's just jump into the settings real quick. There's a lot of stuff you could do. This basically can override your system control for controlling your lock screen. Setting this to be, maybe you want your Mac to be on caffeine for like 15 minutes, but I like to have this on indefinitely because I'm always on my desk most of the time and I just don't want my screen to go off on me. Especially when I'm reading some books and the screen just suddenly goes to sleep, that can get really annoying. You can control your screensaver timings in here. This just turns your Mac into a caffeine monster. In the appearances tab, you could even come in and change the icon of the menu and select the one you want. I'm really liking this eye thing because it makes you look like you're cracked on with 5 cups of double shot. Yeah, okay, let's just get back to the video. You can just go ahead and download it from the App Store. The final app we're gonna cover on is, you might have guessed it, it's Raycast. There is no other app that is as impactful as Raycast. So if you're on a Mac, Raycast is probably the app you're gonna have to have on your device. If I try to do a combo of applications that work together really well, I would put Karabiner and Raycast together as of right now, because we have just set the Hyperkey in Karabiner Elements. Of course, there are other ways to do it, but this seems really effective as you can set it on any keyboard. Now, if we come into Raycast and go to the Advanced tab, we can actually set a Hyperkey, and our Hyperkey is going to be shown as a star instead. You don't have to actually check the box for this to work. Now, what we're actually gonna do is just bind our Hyperkey to open an application. Okay, let's say I wanna open Notion, and we come in here, Hyperkey 9, and that's it, the key bind set. So now if we go Hyperkey 9, and it should just open Notion straight away. And Hyperkey 9 will just close the Notion app again. Let's try setting another keybind for Google Calendar, and that should just open Google Calendar for us. So if I go Hyperkey 7, there you go. Opens as expected. If I do Hyperkey 7 again, it closes it. Now let's open Notion with Hyperkey 9, and there you go. And you can just switch between them now, very easily, just like that. For all the Vim guys out there, Raycast has Vim motions built in right here, so you can just come in here in the Advanced tab and select Vim style, and that should just work fine. So what I'm actually going to do now is Command Space, and I can just do Control J and K to move up and down. So Vim motions is supported in Raycast, and I'm just all for it. I've already made a video covering everything you need to know about Raycast. In short, it's just a spotlight killer and an off-road killer as well, in my opinion. I will leave the link in the description down below in case you guys want to check Raycast out. And so that is gonna be it for this video. Anyways, thank you guys for listening and sticking till the end. If you like this video, be sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.